Now, what are the structures to be seen? First, the most important, you need to identify the Schwalbe's line. This is a model of the eyeball, the plastic model, and I put it on a slit lamp and I get this video. You see here, this is the iris. The reddish part is the ciliary body, and this is the trabecular meshwork. This is the scleral sphere, and we get here the Schwalbe's line. This is the light of the slit lamp. Up here you have the cornea, and down here you get the opaque sclera. As you notice here, you can see a section in the cornea. This is the inner surface and this is the outer surface of the cornea. And in between you get the stroma. While down, you just only get the inner surface of the sclera because the sclera is opaque. So this is the location of the Schwalbe's line between the cornea and the sclera. And this is what you need to do on a slit lamp to locate the Schwalbe's line. So, this is the inner surface of the cornea, outer surface of the cornea, and in between we have the sclera. In between we get the stroma, and have behind here the sclera. You see this convex line, if you go from the out, convex in, this location, this is where the Schwalbe's line is present. Here in this drawing, this is the inner surface of the cornea, outer surface, and in between you get the translucent sclera, and you get this curved line, and here we get the opaque cornea. So this is the location of the Schwalbe's line. Here, this is the section in the cornea, inner, outer, and this is the end of the cornea, and this is the beginning of the sclera, so this is the location of the Schwalbe's line, and this is the trabecular area. You see it? This is the where the Schwalbe's line is. So posterior to it, we get the trabecular meshwork. This is the most important sign you have to look for while examining the gonio. So, inner surface, outer surface, in between stroma, opaque sclera, then you get here the Schwalbe's line. Here, and if you get a widened bend, it should be here. Posterior to it, you get the slightly pigmented trabecular meshwork. This is the location of the Schwalbe's line. Trabecular meshwork slightly pigmented. Canal phlegm usually we don't see it because it is embedded inside the trabecular meshwork. Then we can see this part of the ciliary body. We call this the ciliary recess. It is here, this dark zone here. So we get this gray pigmented part of the trabecular meshwork. This light brown is the iris. This dark brown is the ciliary body, the anterior surface of the ciliary body. We call it the ciliary recess. These fine pigmented bands are the iris processes. These are the uveal part of the meshwork, the trabecular meshwork. This is a normal, being thin bands. So if you see this video, this is the video of an open angle. These fine lines are the fine trabecular, the iris processes. This is the location of the Schwalbe's line, and this slightly pigmented zone is the trabecular meshwork, and the scleral sphere is here behind. This is the scleral sphere. So get the Schwalbe's line here, scleral sphere here, and the zone in between. The trabecular meshwork, And this different pigmented than this one, this area, the ciliary body, the ciliary recess, and these fine bands are the iris processes. If you see all this, it's an open angle. It's a widely open angle. While in this video, none of these are seen, so it's a closed or occludable angle. You cannot be sure it's a real closed or not unless you do indentation gonioscopy.